explain you about the cyclones. What do you mean by cyclones? We all know that if the cyclones occurs, there will be existing of 3 to 1 weeks. So there are in the cyclones, it has been categorized into tropical cyclones and extra tropical cyclones. Tropical cyclones and extra tropical cyclones. How it has been categorized? See, if we consider a graph, this is a radial distance. It is a radial distance, and it is being called as pressure in millibar. We all know that the cyclones occurs in the ocean. See, it is called as the center. Means in Kannada it is called as kendrabindu. See, if we consider this is the center part, automatically it is called as I. Okay. So what happens in the cyclones? The aerial distance would be of 100 to 200 kilometers. The aerial distance would be 100 to 200 kilometers. The center which will occur the cyclones in the ocean is called as the I. And similarly, it has been formed in the low pressure area. It has been formed in the low pressure area. Okay. The minimum pressure is 915 millibar. So this is the general tendency of the tropical cyclones. How it occurs? In the sense, it occurs in the ocean. The center part, what we call, it is the height. What is the radial distance? The radial distance covers 100 to 200 kilometers. It is in the circle. How these cyclones will form? The cyclones, it is in the anti-clock. Okay? It is in the anti-clock. What happens? It will be in the anti-clock directions. The cyclones will form. The duration would be minimum 3 days to 1 week in a duration. The center part is called as the I. It is being formed in the oceans. Okay? The pressure, it has been recorded in the pressure, that is in millibar. The minimum pressure is 915 millibar pressure. Okay? Next comes to, what do you mean by a extra tropical cyclones? Extra tropical cyclones is nothing but these cyclones will be formed in the northern hemisphere region. It has been formed in northern hemisphere region. In this northern hemisphere region, see, in the tropical cyclones, what happens? The wind will be rotated, mean the air will be rotated in the anticyclones, where in the extra tropical cyclones, it will be rotated in clockwise. And this aerial distance is very large. In the tropical cyclones, it is of 100 to 200 kilometers. But in the extratropical, because it is in the northern hemisphere region, the area would be long. It might be more than 1000 kilometers. And the wind speed is relatively low. But in the tropical cyclones, the wind speed is higher. Wind speed is very higher. In the extratropical cyclones, the wind speed is very low. And the duration of the precipitation is very large. It might be take more than 1 month. So the cyclones has been categorized into two parts, that is tropical cyclones and extra tropical cyclones. The tropical cyclones usually we see, that is in the, it has been occurs in the ocean. The center part we call it as the I. The radial distance would be of 100 to 200 kilometers. But in the extra tropical cyclones, it has been occurred in the northern hemisphere region, and the aerial distance is very high. It might be more than 100 kilometers. The air would be circulated in the clockwise.